Here's what happened. Okay, so on Twitter, Ryan Garcia said, Virgil, let's fight. And Virgil said, we've already been to that movie. You said you've been to that movie.
I already said,
yeah. And then Ryan came back and said, no, Oscar, let's do it. Like, he wants it. He's serious about it.
I don't know. Virgil said yes a long time ago. I know. There's a few fights. There's like a couple fights being, straighten it at me. There's a couple fights being, I believe, negotiated for Virgil because I don't want to say someone's turning it down, but I just maybe they're overvaluing themselves or whatever.
Okay, let me tell you what I told Tank the other day. You're going to have a hard time getting fights because people know they're going to sleep. Virgil's 21-21 knockouts. If they fight him, they want to get paid because they know how it's going to end.
Well, not only that, but sometimes they also know that they need an opponent or something. So they use that to their advantage. But at the same time, I get it. They want to get paid and this and that. But when you're all out about it and you're trying to do something, you can't use if the fight doesn't happen, you can't be using the whole as an excuse because you're talking about
you turned it down. I'm a warrior. I fight the best.
Right. If it's business, it's business. I get it. Shit, man. You got to feed yourself, but.
Especially when you know what's going to happen to you.
Yep.
I mean, what happened to fighters just being confident or believing in himself? Look, we've seen a lot of upsets. Subriel Matias, I thought he's one of the best fighters in the world. He got stunned by a guy. I met the guy that beat him, but most people don't know who Liam Perro is.
I didn't even see the fight.
I'm surprised at that fight. I'm very surprised.
Well, listen, sometimes you fight at home, there's people bugging you, you take the guy, a combination of things.
I didn't even see it.
I only watch our guys. So I don't watch any other boxing.
But you were surprised.
How do you get beat?
Decision.
But I mean,
and they even took a point away from Perro out there, really? Home cooking. Yep. That's with the point taken.
But how did he get? What did that guy do? He boxed him.
Yeah, he boxed him, and Subriel Matias had open shots, but he didn't let his hands go.
Oh, he could.
You're not gonna win a basketball game if you're not throwing.
If you're not shooting,
yeah,
you got to shoot to hit.
But you know, at least they didn't rob the kid. Maybe he was counting on robbing him.
50 here.
Hey, I saw the one of the ESPN things. They were talking about Tim Hardaway Jr. for the Mavericks. That Stephen A. Smith was saying that he was embarrassed that he didn't even have the audacity to because he didn't score no points in 19 minutes. He said he didn't have the audacity to score a foul and he didn't get a foul.
That's funny. He didn't do nothing. Stephen A. Smith, he said today he would like to see Tank and Shakur fight. And he said Haney should stay away from Tank because Tank would sleep him.
He might be right. He might be right. You know, it's fun and fight is two different things. Two different things.
It's Wolverine everywhere. Yeah, that's why.
But your son is one of the hardest workers in boxing. Whether he has a fight date or not, he's working. He's staying ready. He doesn't have to get ready. The number one pop-up lacrosse player in the nation just walked in the gym right now.
What time did you get here, Andy?
I got here late. Probably 1 o'clock.
Oh, sure. We had just left probably.
Yeah, it's weekends in Vegas are getting longer and harder to it's just a lot going on, and Virgil, I've been driving a lot lately.
Good for.
Looks like you have the knuckles for boxing. Those knuckles, they're good for boxing, right, Virgil?
Yeah.
Has he been trained before? His first time he's training?
No, I've trained him a couple times, but he doesn't live with me, so I'm just trying to keep him on his toes.
I think that's really cool.
In case he gets chug splash at school, because he got a fight at school last year and he did all right.
Did you get suspended when you get in a fight?
Did you get suspended? Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, you did. You got suspended. I even made a meme about it. Remember? I made a meme about it.
You said, "Hold on, let me call my brother, Virgil. Are you allowed to, if he gets in a fight in school? Can you help?
What?
If he gets in a fight in school." Another guy calls his brother, and he calls you. Is that fair?
I mean, that goes out the window if he didn't watch my little brother.
That's true. They didn't know Virgil's your brother?
No.
No.
Because he was... I made that.
I like that. It looks like Miguel Cotto.
No, that's Inui. Inui's buddy. I sent this out
that's funny.
On breaking news on ESPN.
That's
suspended funny. From school.
Hey, it happens sometimes.
But, shit, it happens to me a lot.
But after that, the guy didn't bother you since you kicked his ass, right? That's what matters.
Yeah, we're trying to give him do a little, just to learn a little bit, you know? You can put it under if you want to contribute.
But it's part of boxing to train when you don't have a date, to train when you don't have a fight, because you could fight in 5 weeks, and then it's like, why didn't we train?
Yeah, you can have it. Well, some of these guys, well, like for instance, there's been a bunch of guys from here, from Robert Gym, where they were called last second. And they upset the guys because, you know, these guys here are staying ready and they're training. And, you know, you never know when a fight falls through. A fight falls through, then they need somebody, right? For the fight to keep going. So,
and they pay more for last second.
And they'll pay you more.
And they think you didn't train. They think it's an advantage, but.
Yeah, they don't realize that they got some of the. That's why when they get some of these guys from Mexico, they don't realize these guys are training.
They stay ready. Yep.
Yeah. They don't have a choice but to stay ready because they're not signed. They don't have a big promoter. They want to make it. That's the golden opportunity. So they take it. And then some of these guys are not even ready anyways, and they take it. And there's some fine motherfuckers over there.
Okay, Ryan Garcia against Caleb Plant in a street fight. Ryan Garcia, Caleb Plant in a boxing ring.
Look. There's very, very few people that you can say that you shouldn't really fuck with. No matter where they're at, who they are, or where they're from, or whatever. You know, if these dudes say that they'll do something, that there's very, very few people that do that. I can almost promise you and guarantee you that Caleb Plant's one of those guys. I know this stuff because. I know.
Because you're like that.
Well, because we're
but I think
how we're raised, where yeah. we're raised and stuff like that. And everybody, you know, everybody says the same thing, but there's very few people
that live it. Yeah.
Yeah. I know Caleb Plant. I don't know him like that personally, but the time that I was around him, man, the guy's a cool guy, man. Like we after a fight, it was me, Hector, Virgil.
Hector?
Yeah, Beltran, yeah. And Caleb Plant were
Virgil.
We're walking from one of the fights.
Uh-huh.
And he was cool, man. Like he didn't even know who we were. Like, we didn't know each other personally, and he was walking. He had just like a normal dude just hanging out with us. And
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, right?
Yeah, after one of the Canelo fights.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So you're saying that if you fight Ryan, Caleb is walking you out?
Yeah. Hey, but Caleb is cool, though, but that's one of those guys that you just don't fuck with them because they turn on like this, and they don't play, man. And I don't know why anybody would even want to mess with him. He seems such a cool dude. I don't know. I don't get it. But yeah, I would. Some people. If you don't come from the streets, you shouldn't act like you're from the streets. And you know that man has obviously he's had a hard time in life lately. That people like him. You don't know what he's bound to do. You know, people with him, they'll snap. They don't fucking give a fuck. You know, so I wouldn't be messing with Caleb playing. Not only because of that, but, you know, you don't talk about his wife or his kids. You just don't do stuff like that. I'm just raised not to, you know, we're just different.
Okay.
You know, don't do stuff like that.
If Ryan does fight Virgil, what do you think of the fight itself, if it does go down?
Shit, that's a good money fight.
I love the fight, Virgil. I really hope
that's
it happens.
A good money fight. It really is. I mean, It's open. If they
want to
take it.
Virgil has the best record in boxing, 21-0, 21 knockouts.
Hey, you know, I keep telling people, like, you don't realize how hard that is to do. Yeah. To have
100% knockout ratio.
100% on knockouts that high. I mean, let's say even let's just bullshit because people run their mouth. They have no idea how boxing is. Even if you fight a bunch of nobodies. You still got a bunch of nobodies that are fucking game.
Human beings that are boxers that train. It's hard.
That you can't knock out. The guys aren't there to get knocked out. That you can even think maybe they're there for a payday. I don't know. Whichever, however you want to put it, doesn't matter. But a lot of guys, every man has pride. But not to get put
out. Not only that, but Virgil, if it was so easy, everybody would have a record like that. It's not easy.
If that was the case, everybody would be 20-0 and 20 knockouts right now in the first 25.
And they can say whatever about my opponents, but if you look at other people's fighters like Terrence Crawford, Spence, look at their first 15 fights.
Crawford first 25 fights.
Well, you can look at, that's what I'm saying.
Like, anybody. Like,
no, I know.
Anyone, but that's just how professional.
Haney, first 15 fights in TJ. I think you would have 15 bodies on your record if you fought there 15 times.
Yeah, most of these, a lot of people don't realize, like a lot of these top names you know right now, and I don't need to name them. Go look at their box record. They had a lot of fights in Tijuana versus guys that are like this big to them. Like, so.
And sometimes they didn't stop.
And
them.
Then they didn't stop.
And sometimes they lose and they turn the decision around because money's exchanged.
Yeah. It's hard to win by knockout, especially in four rounders.
I remember Nonito was on a streak and he fought this guy Navaez from Argentina that was kind of like Pitbull Crew style. And Nonito beat him for 12 rounds, but Nonito wanted the knockout, and he couldn't get the knockout because the guy curled up and blocked it, took a beating, but just sometimes you're not going to knock everybody out.
It's hard, man. You know, to knock somebody out, not only do you have to have power, but you have to have a high level skill. You got to know how to put someone out.
You have to be very smart.
Yeah, open. It's not about just hitting a guy hard. It's how you hit him. It's where you hit him. It's very difficult. It's very difficult, you know. So.
They don't give an award for the best record, the best, most impressive bear. They should, huh? They give awards for everything these days. Event of the year, fight of the year, round of the year.
Yeah, and then, you know, it's really not too many people know that Virgil is the one that has the highest knockout ratio.
100% knockout ratio of over 20 fights, yeah.
Of the entire world.
Yeah.
In the entire world.
No, but I'm saying, you could say, okay, a kid that's 8-0, 8-9, 17-0. So, but I'm saying, when you get to 20 fights, an 100% knockout ratio is very impressive.
Yeah.
What I'd love to see one day, Virgil, if you can edit for me the whole 20 knockouts in one clip.
Shit.
Do a montage of it, like in 15 seconds. I want to see 15 people.
You don't have to edit anything,
right? No, you do all those memes. You're great at it. Photoshop. Where's Cumbia?
Oh, I don't know. Probably.